สวัสดีครับ welcome to the Decorum's Menswear YouTube channel. So I'm Guy, co-founder of the Decorum Bangkok, and today is a very special episode. It's a sad and as well as happy episode as well, because I think today when it's on air, I think Charles is on his way back to Singapore. So I would like to take this episode as
not a goodbye,
but a send off for Charles to Singapore for our, for his new endeavor. That is also actually very important to us as well. So Charles, I'll let you do the talking.
Okay, thank you, yeah. Guy, and I'm Charles. So ever since we announced our plans to open the Decorum in Singapore, way before COVID, we received so many well wishes and very positive messages. So a very big thank you from the bottom of our hearts. And I'd like to say, this is not a goodbye, but the start of something very interesting. I've been living in Bangkok for the last 6 years, and one of the highlights is getting to know the Decorum team, coming here as a customer, getting to know Guy and Ball, first as, just as a store owners and as a customer, but over time becoming friends as well. And, through lots of discussions, chats, being one of their crazy customers, we are finally taking the big step to expand the Decorum into a new market, which is Singapore, where I live as well. So I look forward to welcoming you guys to the shop once it's open in April 2022.
Before anything else, I think I would like to tell you guys, our first encounter with Charles.
Right here?
Right here. I think back then that was actually when we first started the Decorum. It was actually only Kamakura's at that time. Mm. It was just a few weeks, or maybe the very first week of our opening. And then I think Charles was one of the very first customer.
I didn't know that.
That dropped by to at our store. Mm. And I still remember he bought the first item.
Not even a shirt, but just a small pocket square.
First item was a small pocket square.
Which
I think linen pocket square. In maybe with a sailboat or something.
Is that the right one?
Yeah, I still remember, because that was the very first time that I was doing sales. It's like the first thing that one of the very first sales that happens to me happened at this store. So that's how I remember correctly that he bought them.
I didn't know that. That's cool.
so yes, and and things, friendships, and it turns to now, business partnership.
That's right.
I think that's something that.
And I think I'd like to add that, knowing Guy and the team here, knowing this shop, it also opened my eyes to a slightly, a quality way of dressing, buying, not exactly buying less and buying the best, but, making decisions based on long-term thinking. I never thought that way until I met you guys. Yeah. So, I think over time as well, it's been 4 years. I think I graduated from being a biggest spender at one point of time, no longer, to, earning the privilege of being a partner with you guys as well. Because the more we shared drinks together, and the more we chatted, and the more I hung out here over weekends, and even going on trips together, I think it became very apparent that a lot of our thinking was very aligned, and Singapore was always at the back of our minds as a market to go into. And we decided, having over champagne in Tokyo 2 years ago, that we should do it. We should try it. And we even went to Singapore to hunt for a shop space together just before COVID struck.
Right.
So everything is, there's been some delays along the way, but I think the best thing about what's happening right now is that I am actually uprooting myself, leaving Bangkok, which has been my home for 6 years, and going back home to Singapore, and I'll be personally managing the shop as well as also preparing for the opening. Mm. And of course, I've been spending the last few months here with Guy, Ball and the team here to learn the ropes of retail, because it's not something I'm familiar with. Being a customer is different from running a shop. And of course, there are similarities when it comes to the pleasure of it all, the passion keeps you going, but understanding the basics of how to run a shop is important. And I think, having spent the last 3 to 4 months here, nothing is ever enough, but it's giving me a good foundation to go back and work closely with the team here to ensure that we have a successful opening and also a successful business in the Little Red Dot.
So this question goes to Charles. So this move will be quite a bold move, and so how do you feel, or what's you know, is your heart pumping right now? How do you feel about actually going home and open your very first retail shop?
Well, you know, it's a very loaded question. I don't really know how to answer it, to be honest. You know, my mind just keeps shifting. But I guess in general, it's excitement. You know, you have to be excited about doing something like this. Mm-hmm. Not everybody gets a chance to take the essence of Bangkok's leading menswear store and be able to, you know, gain the trust of the original founders to set it up in a new market. That takes a fair bit of gut on both sides. So, you know, it's with that confidence that the team here are putting on me, and also with on my end, it's the confidence that I can also rely on the team here for ongoing strength and expertise. So it's going to be a difficult move. It's my first time doing something like this. Always been a corporate man. Opening a shop is a different ball game. But I'm sure the team, with the help of the team here and with the support of the local community in Singapore, and as we grow, you know, I think over time it's going to equalize itself. It's going to pan out well, and you know, we're going into this with full confidence. And as I told Guy last week, I am not the kind of person who puts my career on hold for something I'm not sure about. So we're definitely going to make it a big success. You know, small easy start, small but sure footing, but over time we do want to be a big part of the evolving menswear community in Singapore.
Yes, to add to Charles, I think what we're bringing to the Dekram Singapore is will be quite similar, and I also think that the decorum now, and as we have developed over 5 years, we have grown over 5 years. Then we started to have our own identity. You know, it's not a we are classic menswear, but I think we bring something that is also casual. You know, but not overly vintage. I think it's a mix of. I think that's how we have progress over 5 years, and I think we are very confident in our identity, and you know, in the way we express it through social medias and everything, and that's going to be exactly the same something that we'll do as well, continue as well in Singapore. You know, the offering and many things, and
a mix of classics as well as some off duty and a touch of fun. I think that's a way to,
and the communities that I'm sure there's a community already, but you know, hopefully we'll be able to do a lot of cooking as well.
That's right. So you're bringing pizzas into Singapore.
I hope so. We'll bring some Uni ovens to Singapore, and yeah, I hope that you know it's something that definitely that that'll be something that.
And I think for me, what sets the Dekorum Bangkok apart really is the sense of community. You know, many of us as friends of the shop, you know, we are customers and also friends. We treat this place as a second home. Many drop by on weekdays, weekends, and we really want, you know, what we hope for Singapore is to have that kind of feel as well. And that's why we're going to be looking for a shop space in Telok Ayer to be close to many of our, you know, like-minded shops, like-minded community. So you can, you know, at one quick visit to this whole neighborhood, you can be coming to us and also then dropping on to the other shops. And it's this whole ecosystem that we want to be proud of, to be part of as we are entering the country.
Okay, Charles, so I've got another question for you, you know, probably on behalf of
everybody,
the audience as well in Singapore. So what will we be bringing to Singapore? You know, what makers, you know, what trunk shows and so on.
Sure. So what the Singapore, the Dekorum Singapore will feature, first and foremost, this store opened with Kamakura shirts, and likewise, Singapore will be the home for Kamakura shirts as well. So made in Japan. So over and above that, we'll also be featuring tailoring from Casa del Sato, our friends in Seoul. Likewise, some accessories from Drake. And when it comes to the footwear side of things, we will have Crockett and Jones, Fugashin shoemakers, as well as Baudouin and Langa, as well as and also it's not all just classic stuff that we carry, not just all formal stuff, things for fun as well, as we are changing as well the way we look at menswear. So we'll be carrying CQP, and also over time we've been developing our own house label. House branded products in collaboration with the great artisans around the region and around the world. We'll be slowly introducing that over time as well. And of course, not everything that's being featured in this store makes it to Singapore for various reasons. You know, it's a case of market relevance. But we're also happy to give a bit of a preview that we've been in very advanced discussions with a very well-known Sartoria in Italy, and it's very likely that we'll be their representative and also stockist as well as partners in Singapore for the long run as well. So watch this space. We have a lot of interesting things planned out, not just in Singapore, but also here in Bangkok, in all our stores within this group. Okay, so what can Singapore, our friends in Singapore, expect from the Decorum? I'll show you around the shop and give you a preview as to what we might be bringing into our new store. Okay, so in Singapore, we'll be featuring Kamakura shirts, a selection from our favorite Japanese shirt maker. We will also be bringing CQP into Singapore. And what else is there? There's also Ascot Chang, made exclusively for the Decorum, and also tailoring by Casa del Sarto from Korea. So in Singapore at Decorum, we will also have our version of the shoes room, and we will be carrying shoemakers like Crockett and Jones of Northampton, as well as Fugashin, Fugashin shoemaker from Japan, and Belgian loafers by Baudouin et Lange. So I look forward to seeing you guys in Singapore once we're ready to open. Thank you guys.
So yes, the time has come, and you know, we'll miss you here, but we all know that it takes like 2 hours, Ooh. Hour and a half to travel to Singapore, and I'm sure that the teams here will be visiting
for sure.
Singapore quite a lot, and likewise Charles will probably, you know, will be, you know, back and forth between Singapore and Thailand quite a lot. So in any case, you know, I think from the bottom of our heart, our team, you know, friendships, I think we bid you a very good farewell.
Not a goodbye.
Yeah. Not a goodbye. Definitely not a goodbye. But you know, we'll miss you. Mm. You know, we'll miss our dinner together. Mm. You know, and many things. And but again,
as they say, one chapter closes, another opens. Mm. I'm just shifting countries, just moving homes. The purpose is clear. You know, I've been spending so much time in this shop, and we are opening a new branch in Singapore. So you know, to many of the friends I've made in this shop and in this store, as well as in Bangkok, you know, thanks for your support. Even though I'm gone, please keep coming by, because the team here are happy to assist you. And as and when, you know, when the Singapore store opens next year as well, and you know, hopefully as the travel situation becomes a lot easier with no quarantine, you know, I hope that we can welcome our friends from around the world into both our stores in Singapore and Bangkok. You know, having it, and for us, it's really the excitement of opening something we love and maintaining it, and you know, making a good shop, good space out of it in two of the coolest cities in Asia.